Hello, welcome to Draw With Me. I am Danny Gregory, and you're here, and I'm glad to see you. I hope that you're ready to do some drawing today. I hope that you have pens and maybe pencils, certainly some paper, possibly in sketchbook form. You decide. You are in control. And we're going to have some fun. We're going to do something interesting, something that I've been thinking about for a while, and I think it'll be an interesting experience. At least I'm looking forward to it. So let's get on. I see there's a bunch of familiar faces joining us today, and possibly a few new ones. So new. I'm not sure that I've met you before, but I'm glad that you're here. And Wendy, hello as well. Sandra, and J-Ro. Hello, J-Ro. Yes, it's nice to see you all. And if you've never been a part of Draw With Me before, let me explain the basic idea. It's an opportunity to just hang out and spend half an hour, 45 minutes, an hour, or maybe the rest of the day just drawing. Drawing, not doing good drawings necessarily, although a lot of times we do end up doing good drawings. A lot of times, though, we just have fun and it doesn't really matter. But, you know, making drawing into a habit is just a great thing to have in your life. It's just, it's a pleasure. It is a way of understanding the world around you better, understanding yourself better, getting a sense of accomplishment, possibly wrestling with a few demons. Those always seem to show up, demons or monkeys. The monkeys, the inner critic in our head. But having drawing as part of your life is just, to me, it is an opportunity not to make art, quote unquote, but rather to be alive, really. To be alive, to enrich our lives with creativity. And so that's what we're going to do today. And I generally pick some random thing to draw, because it doesn't really matter what we draw. What matters is that we do draw. As you saw from the little cavalcade gallery slideshow at the beginning, last week we did a thing called 10 and 20, where we did 10 random drawings of things that started with S in 20 minutes. Today we're going to focus on a single subject, and or a single category of subjects. It's possible we'll do several drawings. Don't know yet. We'll see. See how it goes. See how the time passes. See how whether our interest flags. But we will see. See how it goes. Hello from Berlin and Samantha from Halifax. Very nice. Good. Andy, I'm glad that you're here as we are. It's nice to watch these recordings. I often go back and look at them too. But I think knowing that we're all here together, that there's a couple hundred people gathered by their computers and iPads all drawing together, just makes it that much more fun. So yes, I'm glad that we're all here. Connie from Germany. And who else? Ooh, Miaurizio from Russia. That's exciting. Good. Well, it seems like the whole world is represented. Kosha, I'm glad that you're here too. Kosha and I have a little mini surprise for you that we will be showing you later on. So that's great. Kovaka from Guadalajara. Beautiful. And Anina from Madrid. So yes, all right. And of course, Barbara from Massachusetts. So, oh my gosh, Catherine from Provence. So, all right. So the world is represented, the world of art and the world of artists. So that's cool. All right, let's get on with it. Where should we go next? Well, I want to remind you about our watercolor pencil workshop. This is going to be a lot of fun, and it's going to be a little bit over a week away. Now, I have to tell you, this is going to be our last public workshop for a while. I'm not sure when we'll be back with them. We will be doing a different kind of workshop. But if you've never taken a sketchbook school workshop and you'd like to, If you've never really mastered watercolor pencils and you'd like to, if you'd like to have some fun, join us on January 22nd at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. I'm not sure what time your time it is, but we will all gather and we will draw and we will learn some new skills with a medium that is something we can sort of think we know how to use. But when you see how Kate Legale uses it, you'll realize that there's incredible potential that you'd never tapped into before. So we have that to think about. What else? We have, yes, the Art for All podcast. This is turning out to be a really fun adventure. Every week I sit down with my friend John Muir Laws, who is kind of like the god of nature journaling. And we talk about just a topic. We tend to kind of meander all over the place, but we spend, I don't know, we try to keep it to an hour. It's difficult, honestly. We both like to jabber, but we bounce off each other nicely. And, you know, so we've made this podcast. You may have noticed also that we recorded the video portion of us jabbering, and we share it on YouTube. So you can watch it if you prefer, or you can just listen to it while you're out and about, or you can put it on the background while you're drawing. That is a good use of it, and I think a lot of people are doing that. So that is nice. I see that some folks are enjoying it. Emma likes it. Lisa says it's like eavesdropping. We'll bear that in mind, but it seems like a lot of you liking it. So what supplies will you need today? It's really up to you. I'd get something with color. That would be a good idea. We're going to be drawing one or more beautiful beetles. And I don't mean John Paul, what's his name, and Ringo, George and Ringo. We did them already. And we're never going to do them again. But actual beetles are spectacular. And I have a bunch here that we're going to be able to look at and draw. And so I would say use your imagination. You know, they're colorful, so you might want some color, as I said, but it's up to you, really. That is all that you need. All right, good. Vicky, we're glad that you're back. And Disfake, I'm glad that you like the podcast. And same with Buttercrafts. Like butter. So good. All right, let's talk about what we're going to do today. Let's get on with it. All right, so I'm going to be using this gray book from Hahnemühle, and the good news is you might be using the gray book from Hahnemühle too, because our friends at Hahnemühle have given me a whole bunch to give away. And at the end of today's broadcast, I'm going to share with you information as to how you could enter into the drawing for one, as it were. These are beautiful books, hardbound, and they are called the gray book because, guess what, the paper is gray. But it's really nice to draw on. It's not for watercoloring specifically. What does it say? It says traditionnel Künstlerpapiere von Hahnemühle werden nach alten Rezepturen aus hochwertigen Rohstoffen und reinem Gelwasser hergestellt. Okay, so I think that clarifies things. If you don't speak German, well, you'll be glad to know that they've been making paper from pure spring water since 1854. But this particular book is a light gray sketch paper with non-absorbing surface for India ink, fountain pens, and acrylic markers. I'm going to be using colored pencils on it. And ink, probably. So, yeah. So we're going to be giving a bunch of these away, and I hope that you win one, because they're pretty cool. Okay. I see that JJ is already telling you. Okay. Yes. She will explain what we need to do. We'll do that later on. Okay. So let's get on with it. Let's have a look at our beetles, shall we? Okay. Look at that guy. This beautiful creature is a scarab beetle. I mean, look at the color of that. It is amazing. So let's get on with it. Let us draw the scarab beetle. Now, here's what I would say to you. It's up to you what you want to do. Do you want to, let me get this whole page here. Do you want to draw him really realistically? Or do you want to use, I mean, it has almost like a science fiction kind of quality to it, right? I mean, this could be something out of Star Wars. It's so beautiful and strange and large. All the beetles that I'm going to show you today, I've got half a dozen beetles on stage. They're all big. They're all big, like this big. Like that big. Which is kind of horrifying, but also sort of amazing and beautiful. So we will try and see what it's like. And I'm going to be drawing on this gray paper, which is interesting because it means that I can use white, and I can see how colored pencil works on it, and various other things. So, yeah. So let's get going. Let's get going on this. I think I'm going to make mine nice and big. Right? Why not? I'm going to make it big. Maybe I'll make it. Do I want to? I'm just debating whether I want to use a brush pen or a marker. What do I think? Still not sure. You know what? Maybe. Let's go right in with a pencil. And then maybe I'll use my marker or some kind of pen later on to add detail. Yeah. There's no law that says you have to start with line. You can start with color. This thing is beefy, isn't it? Meaty. Something like a little beetle meat. You've heard the album Meet the Beatles. Sorry, this is taking a strange turn. You've heard it. It's a classic. Well, now, how about a little beetle meat? Not beetle juice. If you squeeze them, you get beetle juice, but that. Something grosser than having beetle juice on your hands. Let's get some other colors going. Because the shape is so strange. I mean, the shape isn't terribly strange, but I mean just the idea of this beetle and it's the way it looks, it's strange. So you could really take it into all kinds of interesting directions. You know, you could add textures to it. You could do the whole thing just in a bunch of lines. Decision. All right, let's get on with the good bits. It's beautiful. I imagine light on it moving beautifully. Light, I mean, it's iridescent, right? So I imagine it would sparkle and shimmer and change colors. It's always so amazing when nature has incredible kind of color features, like, you know, like if you've seen, is it like a cuttlefish or even some kinds of squids, I think, do this where they change colors and flash iridescence and do all these amazing. I mean, I seem to remember reading somewhere that hummingbirds are so beautifully iridescent and colored, but that actually they're not really the colors that they appear to be. Now, let me try and see if I can explain what I mean by that. So you take a hummingbird that appears to be green or blue, and if you actually study the color of the bird itself, it actually is fairly colorless or even kind of bland. But in fact, it's the appearance of color comes from the fact that it is reflecting the light. You know, it is bouncing back the light at us and only certain parts of the spectrum, I guess. So what appears to be color isn't really color. It's more just like a incredible ability to refract light. I think that's really amazing. So I don't know if that means that under certain circumstances it will appear to change color. Maybe that's what's going on with those cuttlefish and squids and stuff. So that they're changing the things that reflect the light, like they're changing, almost like bending a mirror. Is that what they're doing? Maybe some of you know. Maybe you have some marine biologists or some such smart people out there can explain it. But gotta make sure I get these legs to be the same length. I can imagine like a car being painted with paint that has those qualities, right? You can imagine that. Is there anybody out there that says? Yes, Karen's mentioning how many beetles we have out here and all the different kinds of beetles that we have here in Phoenix. I've seen a few. When we first arrived here, there was a beetle that was kind of dropped. I don't know if it was dropped on me. I can't remember exactly, but it appeared. And then I realized, and it was beautiful. It was like blackish green. It might have even been one of these kinds of beetles. And then discovered that, in fact, it was bitten in half. Somebody had gotten to it already. And it was actually half beetle. Sort of like, Pete Best. Is it Pete Best or is it George Best? Pete Best is the football player. All right, I'm being fairly literal here, as I can see. I'm looking at this. I'm just sort of copying the colors that this beetle has. I think I'm going to draw another one in a minute, and when I do, I'm going to be a bit more adventuresome. I mean, you got to wonder what the evolutionary process was that led to these creatures looking like this. It's an incredibly interesting creative adaptation, but I'm not sure what they were adapting to exactly, unless they're basically what they're doing is just saying, hey, don't eat me because I look really weird and I'll taste really weird. I think it's probably that simple. It's just like, I'm ugly, I'm horrifying, stay away from me. It's a fairly straightforward message. Don't mess with me. right now, through the miracle of gray paper, that's right, we can add some white. How often, I mean, I can see, look at that white pencil. It is pristine. I think that's the original, just about the original sharpening. No, that's not true. I think, yeah, it might be. That might be the very first time I ever sharpened it. It was like that. Maybe it even came that way, and I've never used it. Even though I know that's not true, because I have used white pencils, but not that often. But with this gray paper, man, this thing is cool as hell. You know, in fact, I might even want to add a little bit of white outside of him just to make him stand off the page a bit. And you can, because it's gray paper. Gray paper in a nice book. So, all right, so that's, and yeah, so this white, I'm not sure how successful that was, but it allows you to kind of get the sense that he's gleaming. So, yes. Chris is pointing out that the same thing happens with butterflies, yes. Kashav, thank you. I appreciate your liking my books. That's very nice. Yes, Pete Best was. It was Pete Best. Yes, it was Pete Best. George Best was the soccer player. So, yes. As Jen points out, adapting to leaf blowers. No leaf blowers today. You'll have to come back next week if you'd like to enjoy the symphony of leaf blowers. No. This week they're leaving me alone. All right, let's move on. Let's do another one. Let's maybe try a different approach. Fresh page, insert coffee. What brand of colored pencils am I using? Karen would like to know. These are Winsor Newton colored pencils. I just noticed that white one is a watercolor pencil. Right, well, next time I'm going to use a regular non-watercolor pencil, so I'm going to use that. But these are the studio pencils, I think they're called. Okay, let's check it out. How about that guy? Now, this is a stag beetle. It is a stag beetle. How do they reproduce? Because if they're always stag, you know. Do they, stag would imply that they don't mate for life or don't mate at all. Maybe they just don't mate. Maybe they just shack up. Maybe they don't shack up at all. Maybe they, what is the term? Hook up. All right. For some reason, I'm drawn to start in the middle here. You notice that despite saying that I was going to be adventuresome, picked up a brown pencil. Now, brown pencils, you think, is that really your idea of adventure, Gregory? A brown pencil? Ugh. You know, I've been, it's a pandemic. It's a pandemic, and a brown pencil might be the most adventuresome thing I'm capable of right now. That's sad. Speaking of the beetle, doesn't this part looks like the hood of a VW beetle? It does. This bottom part, I wonder if that's where God's name, probably not. Maybe you did. How would you feel if you're holding this thing? Would you be really squeamish and or would you hold it as if you were holding a puppy? No. A rabbit? No. A rat? A rat. Man, look at all the kind of bottle openers and various other things. It's like the Swiss Army knife of beetles, this guy. It's really kind of cool. Really, it seems to have like different functions for all these different protuberances. And this almost looks like it's sort of like elephant skin, like this top part at least. Seems to have this sort of like little pebbled texture, as if it was like a Samsonite suitcase or something. I think that's where Samsonite actually got the idea for the surface, was from the head region of the scarab, of the male stag beetle. Okay, here comes the adventure. I'm switching to a different kind of brown. Woohoo! That's not even the brown I wanted. All right, now I'm really getting nuts. I'm switching to yet another brown. That's the brown I wanted, more of a chestnutty kind of warmer brown. Really, when I thought about doing this drawing, I really had this intention of doing something that looked like it was like a science fiction, like piece of military equipment, you know, and I was going to like exaggerate the weaponry and stuff. But then for some reason, when I came to doing it, I didn't do that. So what's going on? I guess not as adventuresome as I'd hoped today. Happens, you know, sometimes you're less risk averse. Sometimes you're more of a risk taker. We are always in flux. Don't you think that's true? Don't you think you change? No matter how old you get, you still change. You may, even if you're set in your ways, you still change. You have to change. We have to adapt to what's going on. And so we have to be kinds of creatures that change, that flex and change. And sometimes you don't even know that you've changed. You don't even know what's going on inside of you. But then you start drawing. And if you're paying attention to your drawing, you might suddenly start to realize, well, it's saying something about you. And how I'm What is it saying about me? Where's my black pencil? Here it is. You know what? Sometimes when we have problems, we think about ourselves and how we're reacting. But maybe on a lesser level, you know, we just kind of go on. We're just subsisting, not necessarily paying attention to how we are. Then you do a drawing and you go, oh, that's interesting. I wonder why I took that turn. Now, it's possible to say, oh, I just did a bad drawing. Bad. Didn't turn out like I thought. Like I didn't end up doing all those cool things I was planning to do. Or I tried doing them and they turned out to be really bad. Maybe the reason they turned out to be bad is you're not actually, that's not actually what you wanted to do. You thought that's what you wanted to do. But then some part of you, when you set out to do it, it was like, I don't really want to do this. I'm not really concentrating. I kind of want to do something else, but all right, this is where we're going. I guess we'll go there. You know what I'm saying? It's like we, as the poet said, we contain multitudes. And sometimes those multitudes are in conflict with each other. Directions we didn't want to. And I think it's important to think about that because too often we can just come up with a blanket judgment about ourselves and go, yeah, you know what? I suck at drawing. I can't draw beetles or whatever it is you say. Or I can't draw cool science fiction things. Or I can't follow up on a plan. I can't follow through with what I was going to do. Like, okay, maybe it's something more interesting going on than just a blanket condemnation. Maybe you need to look at yourself a bit more subtly. I mean, this beetle is nothing like I thought I was going to be painting or drawing, or whatever it is I'm doing. But it's okay. It's sort of interesting. But I think I'm ready to move on to another guy. What about you? Ready? Shall we move on? We're done with the stag beetle. It's leaving. Ready? It's gone. It's been replaced by this extremely cheery looking guy. I mean, come on. This is a jewel weevil. It wobbles, but it don't fall down. Jewel weevil. Okay, now this, I have to change things up here. This guy is going to get a different kind of treatment. Has to, because he's so nutty. So I'm switching to this brush pen, because this guy is just, he feels like he's wearing some kind of a cheap acrylic jumper that was picked up in like a flea market or something. And it's cheery, it's chipper, it's cool. It's not sort of elegant or threatening, but it also doesn't look appetizing, right? You really wouldn't want to eat this guy. So if you're a bird and you see one of these jeweled weevils, you'd say, yeah, what else is there around to eat? Not sure that guy's going to do it for me. Now look at these strange hands that he has. Interesting. Interesting eyes, a big nose, and then these antennas. Kind of cool. Beefy, definitely beefy. Substantial, kind of thorax. here. All right, so I think he still needs some color, though, because I think his color is very much what defines him. Do I have any colors that won't work? Let's see. Can't really see that. Can't really see it. Not enough. Not good enough. I don't have exactly the right guy. Oh, maybe this guy will do. This guy. There we go. Right. Not too bad. And then a bit of this. Sorry, I'm just perusing my collection of colored pencilania. Go ahead. What do you think? Looser. I kind of like it looser. It's a bit more. This is, I think, the way I should have been doing them all along. I kind of had that temptation. First, I was going to grab that brush pen. I said, meh. No, I think I won't. I think I'll try it with a thing, but it feels like that's what it needed. It needed some. It just needs to be bold. It's more fun than this. See, that looks, yeah. I could go back in, I suppose, and put some black lines on top of these guys, but no, I'm not going to. I can't be bothered. I'm moving ahead. All right, so that is the jewel weevil, and here we have the almighty scarab. We've seen a scarab already, so I'm not sure why he's there. Let's see him instead, the Hercules. Now that looks... It looks like a weapon or a screwdriver. But I think it deserves the same treatment. Better. I want it nice and loose, though. This is feeling, there's something about him that's making me want to be nice and loose. Again, it's like this is. The Hercules, I think, might be the largest beetle. It doesn't look like it necessarily here on the screen, but it is. I think it's the largest of the beetle. I would hope so. The name, like Hercules? Yeah. That's good. You know what? Let's get a bit... Yes. Well, why not? Gold ink. Gold ink. Isn't it? It's a great movie. That looks good on this gray paper, yo. That looks nice. Can you see? It's reflective. Yeah, that's nice. Good call, Gregory. Yeah, that's Winsor Newton calligraphy ink. That was a good one. All right. And now, just because I can, this is an Oral-B. Medium soft. This is India ink. Where's my India ink? All right. This is India ink. All right, this is going to get messy. All right, that was not quite what I intended, but it's kind of cool anyway. I had thought I was going to put some speckles, not two gigantic blobs, but such... You're probably saying to yourself, well, of course that happened. What did you think was going to go on? But yeah. That wasn't quite what I thought was going to happen, but I don't mind that it did. That is gray ink. It doesn't, may not look like it right now because it's still wet, but it is. All right, so now let me just do this. Let me just label it. What do you think? That would seem like a good thing to do. It's a Herc. Now, I was going to go back and label the others, but now this is all wet, so to hell with it. All right. I think now that my thumb is black, yes. You've heard of green thumbs? Green thumb means you're a good gardener. Black thumb means... the Empyrean Vole points out that this beetle was squished. I like that. All right, my beetle was squished. So let's move. Let's step away from this disaster. It's not a disaster. It's not. It's a serendipitous accident, happenstance. Thing that happened. It's one of those things you go back to years later and you go, what the hell was I thinking? Why did I splash all that ink all over that reasonably good drawing? Well, I'll have to come back and watch this video to know what happened. It's now it's all been recorded. I can do forensic analysis later on. Okay, cool. Let's go back. You know what? Shit happens. Yes, stuff happens. Sprinkle some more gold on top. That's not a bad idea. Let's wait till it dries. We'll see how far it gets, and then we'll deal with it later on. Because that gold was a stroke of genius. Okay, what did I want to do? Oh, yes. So let me quickly turn to a treat that is a sketchbook tour. We do this every week. We show a sketchbook tour of a great artist, or failing that, one of mine. But this week we do have a great artist. We have my friend Kosha Kona. She has so graciously shared a video of, I think her most recent, isn't your most recent sketchbook, Kosha? I think it is. I don't remember you saying that exactly, but let's assume it is. I think it's fairly recent. And I mean, Kosha is a great sketchbook artist, carries a sketchbook with her everywhere. So, no, there are no more Beatles. We're done. It's 49 past the hour. Yes, Kosha says yes. This is a new one. Here we go.
Never forget to put your contact details in the front of your sketchbook. It's a great way to loosen up and start your sketchbook. Yeah, so these are my daily drawings. They were online sessions. This was actually done during an online course I took with Melanie Rehm and Veronica Lawler, which was really great. And I was thinking maybe I shouldn't put it in my sketchbook because they are lessons and I will be messing up. But I'm so glad it's now part of the story of this sketchbook because I learned so much and I had such a fun time during a few hours. And after that, I actually really changed a little bit of my angle. Literally, see, this one is from a standing point of view and this one is from sitting down, so a worm's eye point of view. Sitting in the kitchen, two different views on a messy kitchen cupboard, kitchen counter. Session drawing hands. Lots of self-portraits in this sketchbook. I don't know why, it just happens sometimes that I feel like drawing myself often. Also, we went into lockdown again in the Netherlands, so that might have something to do with it, you know, being inside a lot and having less different views. This is my dad. I went for a little walk, a little sketch walk with him. It's so great to be able to draw with my father. My husband on the couch. Three different angles on one same subject. That was a really fun session. From the kitchen counter in the living room. Kitchen again. View from the pantry. Very interesting indeed. My husband doing a music session with his band online. More self-portraits. My husband in the kitchen. And then before you know it, you're at the end of a sketchbook. Just like that.
Just like that. Actually, hold off here a second. Yeah, that Kosha's sketchbook is like a great example of just a companion sketchbook, I would call it. I just coined that term, is that correct? Let's just say it is. It is just her working sketchbook. All the different things that she's doing, the mundane aspects of life, just drawing as a part of a regular daily habit, all different parts of it. So, and you can see she's experimenting with styles, she's experimenting with materials, and she draws a lot, so she draws really well. So that was really cool, and it was nice to see. So thank you, Kosha, for sharing that with us. If you don't know, Kosha does a weekly thing on her channel called Draw Tip Tuesday, and you should go and check it out because she's always showing new techniques, new ideas, and stuff like that. So I hope that you will do that if you have never done it before. Okay. I put this up here because this is the email address that you're going to write to if you are in the United States or Canada, unfortunately, only the United States or Canada, or maybe Mexico, I don't know. If you would like to be considered to get your very own Hahnemühle Gray Book, we have a few to give away, and write to us if you would like. It's a random drawing. But I will be honest with you, the emails that tickle us get a slight advantage. So if you just send send us your name and your mailing address, And tell us why you'd like the gray book if you want to. Tell us why you like drawing beetles. Whatever it is you want to tell us something. And we will fire them out. We will fire them out. So I want to remind you of a few other things on the horizon. Yes, I guess they're on the horizon. Are they on the horizon? No, they currently exist. So, yes, Art for All podcast. Subscribe to it if you want to get just the podcast. You can just do that anywhere. If you get a podcast, have a podcast app, just there it is, Art for All. And you can listen to me and Jack talk about stuff. We do it every Monday. And yeah, love to hear what you think about it too. And if you have any ideas for things you'd like us to talk about, please do. And this workshop, as I mentioned, coming up a week from Saturday. Hope you'll check it out. You can find out information on the sketchbookschool.com website. Danny'sessays.com. Okay, so I write an essay every Friday, which is free. I'm now writing them on Tuesday as well. Twice a week. Lisa likes them. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you for subscribing. Yeah, so sign up for Danny'sessays.com. Or go to Danny'sessays.com to sign up for Danny's essay. You know what I'm talking about. Go there and, you know, I'll send it out to you. It's a thing to do. It's a thing to read. I write about, you know, creative stuff. Drawing, thinking, living, being, beetles, the whole shebang. Finally, subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to it so then you will know when on Mondays I post the podcast, or on Thursdays when we do Draw With Me, or on Fridays when I post an essay, a video essay. Yeah. There's a video. Then, of course, there's also a written essay on Friday, and there's also a written essay on Tuesday, Monday, Tuesday. Wednesday, I just lie by the pool, panting. And then Thursday, I'm here. Scrubbed, clean, thumb blackened. And you'll know all about that because you've subscribed. Would I consider recording my essays and posting them on my podcast? Well, that's called the last season, the previous season of Art for All, in which I did that. I recorded my podcasts, my essays as a podcast, and I did that. It was reasonably good, but I don't do that anymore. I just don't do it anymore. So, okay. Thank you. Thank you for joining me today. Thank you for drawing beetles. Oh, I want to see your beetles. I want to see your beetles. So post them on social media. Don't mail them to info. Do not email them there. That's not the way to do it. Post them on Instagram. Post them on Facebook. Post them in the schoolyard if you're a member of the schoolyard. And if you do post them in the grand social media, whatever the giant conglomerate is that owns Facebook and Instagram, Meta, the metaverse, if you put them out there, just tag them. Hashtag SBS Draw With Me. Here it is, SBS Draw With Me. And then next week, we'll see it. We will see it at the beginning of Draw With Me. Imagine, next week you'll come. This place will be infested with beautiful beetles. I can't wait. That will be really fun. Okay, guys. Thank you. And here's this. Thanks for drawing with me today. We'd love to see what you made. So please post it on social media or put it in the Sketchbook School schoolyard. And make sure to tag it, hashtag SBS Draw With Me. Thanks very much to our sponsors, Hahnemühle and Winsor & Newton. And if you'd like some more inspiration for your creativity, here are three things that you can do. One, subscribe to this channel, and you'll know when I make new videos, which I do every week. Two, sign up for my free weekly newsletter. A lot of people seem to like it, maybe because it's free. And third, watch another video.